A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength. Take to heart these words which I enjoin on you today. Drill them into your children. Speak of them at home and abroad, whether you are busy or at rest. Bind them at your wrist as a sign, and let them be as a pendant on your forehead. Write them on the doorposts of your houses and on your gates. When the Lord your God brings you into the land which he swore to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, that he would give you a land with fine large cities that you did not build, with houses full of goods of all sorts that you did not garner, with cisterns that you did not dig, with vineyards and olive groves that you did not plant. And when therefore you eat your fill, take care not to forget the Lord, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery. The Lord your God shall you fear, him shall you serve, and by his name shall you swear." The word of the Lord.
The responsorial psalm. The response is, "I love you, Lord, my strength. I love you, O Lord, my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. I love you, Lord, my strength. My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Praise be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies. I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord live, and blessed be my rock. Extolled be God, my Savior. You who gave great victories to your king and showed kindness to your anointed, to David and his posterity forever. I love you, Lord, my strength."
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. A man came up to Jesus, knelt down before him, and said, "Lord, have pity on my son, who is a lunatic and suffers severely. Often he falls into fire and often into water. I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him." Jesus said in reply, "O faithless and perverse generation, how long will I be with you? How long will I endure you? Bring the boy here to me." Jesus rebuked him, and the demon came out of him, and from that hour the boy was cured. Then the disciples approached Jesus in private and said, "Why could we not drive it out?" He said to them, "Because of your little faith. Amen, I say to you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, 'Move from here to there,' and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you." The Gospel of the Lord.
The first reading comes from Deuteronomy 6, 4-13. The first part of this reading is the creedal formula that we call the Shema Israel, which begins, "Listen, Israel." That's what Shema Israel means. That the people of Israel are to follow God alone. This is monotheism. They believe that God is the only God. Remember, when the Israelites first followed Yahweh, they were henotheists. They believed that their call was to follow Yahweh, but the other gods existed. They just didn't worship them. Now Israel has become monotheists, and they're to love the Lord with our heart, soul, and strength. In the Bible, the heart means to love the Lord with our intellect, that we should be willing to study about our faith, to know who God is. Soul, that we should love the Lord until they tear the soul right out of our body. We should love the Lord even when it costs us, even in times of persecution. And strength means to love the Lord with our physical possessions, that we're willing to give up everything in order to follow God. We should teach this to our children, that they should know who God is, that we should wear it as a sign on our forehead and on our wrist. Remember the phylactery, where a little bit of the law was written and put into a box, and that box was tied to one's wrist to exemplify that God should guide our every action, the hand being the source of the action. If it was tied to the forehead, God should be behind our every thought, our every sentiment. Furthermore, it should be written on the doorposts of the house. Remember, the Jewish people have a small box that contains some of the law, which is attached to the door frame, and it's called the mezuzah. People, when they enter the house, when they leave the house, should remember that God should dwell in this house, that God should be taken from this house into the world. And Moses reminds the people that they've been given this special responsibility because they have witnessed that this is the God of their ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. And this is the God who has given them the promised land. They didn't dig the wells. They didn't plant the trees or the vineyards. God gave them to them because God has dispossessed another people. Now, philosophically, that's a very difficult concept. Why would God treat the other people so badly? But that's not the point of this reading. The point of this reading is the Jewish people are the chosen people. Therefore, they have to act like the chosen people. We could remind ourselves of that, that God has blessed us. God has been close to us. We have been chosen by God. We should act in accordance with that choice. The Gospel is from Matthew 17, 14 to 20. A man comes up to Jesus and asks for his mercy because his son is a lunatic. Now, that's a term that we wouldn't use today. What's really being described is that he's an epileptic. But remember, in those days it was believed that epilepsy was a form of diabolic possession. So what the man is really asking Jesus to do is to exorcise his son. The man says that he brought this boy to the disciples, but they weren't able to do anything. Why? Jesus implies because they lack faith. They can't trust in his authority. And he says, if you were to have the faith the size of a mustard seed and say to the mountain, move, it would happen. Faith is very powerful. But we shouldn't play with this. At healing services, sometimes the preacher says, if you have faith, then you're going to be healed. Well, it's true to a certain extent, but not necessarily physically healed. Sometimes God has a plan for us, which includes illness. What we should have is a faith that trusts that God will give us the most loving answer possible, that God's ways are very powerful and can change reality, that our prayers, which are faith-filled words, are not simply words, but words that have as much power as the words of creation. Let there be light. Let there be dry land. We have to trust in God with our whole heart, soul, and strength, as we heard in that first reading. And may God bless us.